This is the Faith Fight Podcast. Today we're talking about if Christians should celebrate Halloween. Hello again, everybody. Thank you for tuning into this episode of the Faith Fight Podcast. My name is Chris Curry, and I'm your host, and I'm here to help you get your prayers answered, to encourage you to grow from glory to glory, and to ultimately assist you in achieving your God-given purpose. Thank you for tuning in today. I'm hoping that you are having a great day, and my prayer, as always, is that this episode blesses you. For all my first-time listeners, I want to let you know the podcast is available on all of the major podcasting apps, on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Amazon Music, Audible, YouTube, and I don't know if I forgot anything, but anywhere where you, and I don't know if I forgot any of the apps that I know it's on, but wherever you get podcasts, you can search for the Faith Fight Podcast, and more than likely you will find this podcast there, and you can listen, subscribe, and follow, and you can get every new episode that I release on a Monday morning, and you can use it as part of your daily devotions to help you get into the right mindset as you start your day or as you start your week. And along with getting every new episode that I release, I want to let you know that there's also over 200 episodes that I've done in the past, almost 5 years now, of the podcast, and I've covered a whole bunch of different topics. I recently did an interview with Andrew Smith that covered forgiveness and why it's important to us. I also covered topics such as spiritual warfare, worship from a biblical perspective, and also things like praying for your children. So if you are going through anything that you need help with or need to find Bible verses on, all you need to do is just go into the archives and scroll through the different titles that I've done in the past 2 years. And when you see something that is related to something that you are going through, just click on that episode and play it. And I'll go over the Bible verses related to that topic and agree with you in prayer at the end of that topic so that the promise that God has for you concerning that topic, concerning that issue that you are going through, we come in agreement and we believe God for His best for you. So you can find links to all of the podcasts and apps in the description of this episode, and you can also get to the archives through a link that I've placed in the description of this episode as well. I made it really easy so that you can get to all of those things and be blessed by what I've done in the Faith Fight Podcast over the past 5 years. And for all of my returning listeners, thank you for your faithfulness, and I'm praying that you get an extra special blessing from this episode today, as you may have gotten one in the past. And if you know anyone that you think that will be blessed by listening to what we talk about today, I'm asking you to share this episode with them so that they can listen to it, and may God be glorified as their lives get changed and as they draw closer to God. Now, some of the exciting news that I have for the podcast is that I am now working with other ministries or teachers of the Word of God to help you launch your own podcast. So if you have a ministry and you teach on a weekly basis, or you teach in part of a small group and you want to turn those lessons into podcast episodes and have your very own podcast, I want to help you to do this. I've been doing the Faith Fight Podcast for about 5 years now, and I've been extremely efficient and learned a lot of things about the process of podcasting. So if you have a desire in your heart to get the message of your ministry out there to more people using a podcast, I want to help you to do that. So if you want to do that, you can reach out to me by clicking the link in the description, and I'll be more than happy to talk with you and explain how we can get your message out to more people for the glory of God. So today's topic is if Christians should celebrate Halloween. So there are a lot of things that we people in the world that we do just because the rest of the world is doing it. And we do it not even thinking about it. And we need to give some thought about some of these things and search the Bible so that we know what is acceptable by God's standard. Halloween is one of those things, which is the reason why I'm publishing this episode today. The world sees it as harmless fun, and some Christians follow along and do and participate in it as well. Kids dress up as ghosts and go out door to door for candy, and adults go into work and do a whole bunch of spooky, scary stuff with their coworkers, and Halloween parties happen this time of the year as well. But should Christians participate in it is the question. So first, let me discuss the origins of Halloween. So from my research, the origins of Halloween go back to an ancient pagan festival from 2,000 years ago, celebrated by the Celtic people. The Celtics believe that the dead could walk with the living on this day, and you will be able to visit them during Halloween. The Celtics did not want the spirits that were wandering to bother them, so they wore costumes to make them appear like ghosts. Other people offered the spirits sweet treats in order that the wandering spirits would leave them alone. Over the years, the costumes evolved to include vampires and werewolves and witches and zombies and all those other demonic things. Over the years, the costumes evolved to include vampires, werewolves, witches, zombies, which can all be connected to evil spirits. One of the most notable items related to Halloween is the jack-o'-lantern. During medieval times, people would go door-to-door asking for food in return for a prayer for the dead. They would carry with them turnip lanterns that were hollowed out. And in those lanterns were a candle which represented a soul trapped in purgatory. The lanterns were also used to ward off evil spirits. Now these are the traditions that the Celtic people did. Over time, they started using pumpkins instead of turnips because they were easier to hollow out and carve. Given these details of the origin of Halloween, let's see what the Bible says about it. So this is the first thing that the Bible says about Halloween. The Bible says that we should not consult ghosts or spirits or those who are dead. And I'm going to read Deuteronomy 18 verses 10 to 12. It says, "There shall not be found among you anyone who makes his son or daughter pass through the fire, or one who practices witchcraft, or a soothsayer, or one who interprets omens, or a sorcerer, or one who conjures spells, or a medium, or a spiritualist, or one who calls up the dead. For all who do these things are an abomination to the Lord, and because of these abominations, the Lord your God drives them out from before you." And my second point is that, as mentioned in the origins of Halloween, I mentioned that they offered sweets to the ghosts and demons in exchange for them not to bother them. But the Bible verse that I'm going to mention next says that you cannot fellowship with demons and drink from the Lord's cup at the same time. And I'm going to read 1 Corinthians 10, verse 20 to 21. It says this, "Rather that the things which the Gentiles sacrifice, they sacrifice to demons, and I do not want you to have fellowship with demons. You cannot drink the cup of the Lord and the cup of demons. You cannot partake of the Lord's table and of the table of demons." And the next point that I'm going to bring up is that you cannot fellowship with darkness and light. So God is calling his followers to leave the practices of the world and hold fast to the teachings of the Lord. And I'm going to read 2 Corinthians 6 verse 17. It says, "Therefore, come out from among them and be separate, says the Lord. Do not touch what is unclean, and I will receive you." And this is another verse that we need to remember concerning Halloween. It's Ephesians 6 verse 12. It says, "For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this age, against spiritual hosts of wickedness in the heavenly places." So as this verse is about spiritual warfare, it clearly highlights the battle that we should be in against the wickedness that's in this world. We should not fellowship with it in any matter. Whether we are serious about it or doing it in fun, we should stay away from the darkness of evil. So how should we respond? So it's really difficult in this world when we know that everyone else is going in a particular direction, and it may seem innocent to everyone else, and you know that God's word says to do differently. As Christians, we have to be bold with our convictions and draw the line that we will not cross. I know of a lot of churches who will open their doors on October 31st and have a Halloween alternative for the kids in the neighborhood. Some churches call it Hallelujah Night, or other churches I've heard called it Candy Fest or things of that nature. But what happens at these events is that the church puts on a fun activities and games and give out candies to the kids in the neighborhood. By doing this, we can encourage the kids to have a fun and safe night in the church, and they can dress up in their costumes that are not demonic and scary, and they can still get candy and have fun in the church. My opinion is to allow the kids to still dress up in their costumes if they want to dress up as firemen, or if they want to be a princess, or a doctor, or a pilot. Anything that is not demonic or evil in nature. And this evening is not about scaring people and fear, because there is no fear in love, but perfect love casts out all fear. And that is 1 John 4, verse 18. So I hope that you learned something from this episode. I'm going to pray right now. So if you're doing anything that requires your attention, keep your eyes open. But I'll pray and then you can agree with me as I pray concerning this topic. So Heavenly Father, thank you for hearing our prayer today. We love you. We thank you. We appreciate you. And we thank you for all that you have done to deliver us from evil, to deliver us from pain, and to deliver us, oh God, from the wickedness of the enemy, Lord God, and to save us in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. And we humbly come before you, oh God, and we ask you to cleanse us and forgive us. Every single person listening, Lord God, for if we did anything in our ignorance, oh God, not knowing the truth of what your word says, I pray that you would cleanse us and purify us now. And I ask that your Holy Spirit, oh God, will speak to our hearts concerning this topic that we spoke of today, Lord God. And I thank you, Lord God, that you, oh God, will open the doors of opportunity for us to allow us to have fun with our kids, to dress up in wonderful costumes of things that they aspire to be, Lord God, like doctors, Lord God, or pilots or astronauts, Lord God, and have a fun, safe night in the church or in a good place, Lord God. And I pray, oh God, that they will not, oh God, follow the ways of the world, Lord God, because your word says, oh God, the ways to hell, oh God, is wide, oh God, but the way to eternal life is narrow, Lord. So I thank you, Father God, that as we choose, oh God, to do what you've called us to do and walk that narrow and fine path, Lord God, I thank you that you will bless, oh God, the times, oh God, that we have in fellowship with you, Lord God. And I thank you, oh God, for saving us, oh God, from being entrapped in a worldly system, Lord God. And I thank you that you will deliver those right now who are even listening who are trapped in it, Lord God. And I pray, Father God, that you will allow us to see the true fun, oh God, and the joy that you have for us when we fellowship and do things the right way, Lord God, according to your kingdom principles, Lord God. Because your word says that there is joy in the Holy Ghost, Lord God. So I pray for a fun night for all the kids, Lord God, who are going to have a fun party, oh God, on October 31st, Lord God. Not the world's way of doing it, not a demonic way of doing it, Lord God. But Lord, I pray that there is a fun, oh God, night in a safe environment like a church, Lord God, where the children can have fun and have candy and enjoy themselves in a safe environment that does not connect them to any spiritual demonic activity, Lord God. So I thank you, Father, for this, and I pray, oh God, for every single parent and every single child that may be listening right now. Bless us indeed, Lord God. Help us, and I thank you that you would lead us by the power of your Holy Spirit. And I give you the praise and the glory for this, Lord. In Jesus' name, I thank you and I pray, amen. And that's it for another episode of the Faithified Podcast. I pray that you are blessed and encouraged by this episode. And if you were, go over to Apple Podcasts and you can subscribe there. You can leave a 5-star review and put your testimony in the little comment section of how this episode blessed you or encouraged you or something that you learned from this episode. And if you are on an Android phone, you can subscribe to the podcast and follow through Google Podcasts, Spotify, Amazon Music, and on Audible. And the podcast is also on YouTube. So just search the Faith Fight Podcast and you can find the podcast that way as well. And remember to share this podcast with someone else and put on the full armor of Christ Jesus every single day and go out and fight the good fight of faith. And you'll hear from me again next week on the Faith Fight Podcast. Something good is going to happen to you today. Be blessed, everyone.